Science. Science, very nice. Very nice. Well, we know you was an award-winning actor, writer, director, but you've added, with the podcast, a new title, that's Interviewer.
Yes.
Not so easy, is it, buddy?
No, I love it.
Focused.
I have the best time. I talk to the most interesting people in the world.
You talk to Alan Alda?
I frequently do, as a matter of fact, yeah.
I love one of the questions you ask your guests are, and the podcast is called Clear and Vivid?
Yeah, Clear and Vivid, because it's about communicating and relating. Mm-hmm. So in all fields, all areas of life, like music, we have Yo-Yo Ma and Itzhak Perlman and Tom Hanks have acting, and we even have, you know, every part of life requires good communication. So we had a former chief hostage negotiator for the FBI, and he said his techniques for negotiating the release of a hostage are very useful in a marriage. It's really good.
Which is give them everything they want and try to stop them before they get to the plane. Why did you want to do a podcast? I know it's the hip young
thing.
Well,
the reason I do the podcast is that it's fun.
And you have two.
You have two,
right?
I have two.
So there's Clear and Vivid, and what's the other one?
The other one is Science Clear and Vivid. We devoted mainly, we're doing a series now of women scientists. They're really fascinating.
Well, certainly all science should be clear and vivid. Is that more of a natural?
That's the idea. I mean, scientists need to be able to speak to the public and explain what they do so we understand it, so we can make decisions about what to fund and what to complain about and that kind of thing. But they also have to be able to communicate with one another. And I, for instance, one of our, I'm so proud that the Center for Communicating Science, which I helped start at Stony Brook University, teaches communication to scientists and doctors and nurses. It's important, communication is so important in the doctor's relationship with the patient, for instance. I had the best experience with a doctor. I was in Chile interviewing astronomers on top of a mountain, and I got a wrenched gut. My gut got all caught up and was losing its blood supply. Within about 2 hours, I was going to be dead. Wow. So they took me down the mountain to this little hospital in this small town, and there was this brilliant surgeon there, and he communicated to me so beautifully. He said, here's what's happened. Some of your intestine has gone bad, and we have to cut out the bad part and sew the two good ends together. And I said, oh, you're going to do an end-to-end anastomosis. He said, how did you know that? I said, oh, I did many of them on MASH.